I saw this endgame in the YouTube channel. Red's first move, cannon 2-3, is obvious, preventing the immediate checkmate by Black's pawn 8-7. Black just fit moves with his king while maintaining the checkmate threat with his two pawns. If Red is contented with a draw, he could simply move the cannon up and down the third file. But no, Red has material advantage, so he will want to play for a win. We shall explore in this video if he can do it. If Black plays pawn 7-8 instead, then cannon 3-9, followed by cannon 9-9, will win the pawn and the game easily. Likewise, Black's pawn 7-8 here will be punished by the red pawn 3-4, driving the center pawn away. Oh my god, suddenly Red finds himself in trouble. Moving either the cannon or pawn will allow pawn 8-7 checkmate at once. However, let's take a second look at this position and ask, what if it is Black's turn to move? Interesting enough, Black has no good move. For example, king 6-5? No. The advisor will then destroy the most aggressive pawn right away. Moving either of his pawn? Then the mating threat is temporarily lifted. And this could give Red a breather to turn the table around. Let's replay from the beginning and find out if Red can subtly pass a turn to Black along the way. Here we go. Now comes the critical moment. We have learned from the earlier failure that advancing another step with the pawn will lead to disaster. So can Red pass the turn to the opponent? The answer is yes, as there are still two spots for the cannon to move around. Here it goes. There you are. This is the same position before the cannon 3-2 move. But it's Black whose turn is to move now. This tactic is known as dùn chuò in Chinese, the interjection of an intermediate move, similar to what is known as shì shěn chūk in Western texts. Grandmaster Hu Ronghua has once described this tactic as taking three steps for a distance of two. Liǎng bù fēn chěn sān bù zǒu. Red could now charge forward his pawn. Now Black is forced to move his pawn. If pawn 5-4 instead, Red has a much easier win after k4+1. A timely sacrifice. And Red wins, as Black's pawn will soon be captured one by one. That's all folks, I'm Felix Tan. Thank you for watching my Xiangqi video tutorial. Goodbye.